This video is sponsored by PPA. Hey, beautiful people, I'm Lucy, and today we're gonna do a super simple product photography walkthrough. So by the end of this video, you're gonna be able to take amazing product photos. Now, this is great for you, whether you're maybe starting a photography business, you wanna add doing product photography to that, or maybe you have your own online store, e-commerce store, and you wanna get better product photos yourself. Now, a couple years ago, I did a really beginner product photography video, and that was basically something that you can just put together based on whatever you have in your house. This video is a little bit more intermediate, and that's basically because I'm gonna suggest some really amazing gear that you should invest in if you're doing a lot of product photography, like I said, for clients or for yourself. These are things that are gonna make it so much easier to do really great product photography. Again, you don't need it, but this is my advice if you wanna get started and you wanna kind of set up a home studio for product photography. So let's get right into it. First, we're gonna talk about the gear that you need. All right, so in terms of gear, I'm not gonna go over the top. We're not gonna go to the like super professional level of what you would need, but I am gonna talk about the essentials that I think you should invest in if you are doing this as a business or you're doing photos for an online store or you're just doing a lot of product photography. These are the things that you should definitely have in your kit. So of course, first of all, you need a good camera, something with an interchangeable lens and that you can manually adjust the setting. Next up is the tripod. Now the basic tripods are okay, but when you're talking about product photography, you're probably gonna wanna do those cool top-down shots, you're probably gonna wanna do flat lays. So if you can get a tripod with a swing arm to make that easier for you, you should definitely go ahead and get one. The next thing is backdrops. You can do them in all different kinds of colors. If you're just gonna get one, get white because you can do so much with that. And then you're gonna need something to put those backdrops on. In my first product photography video that was very, very beginner, I actually just tacked it to the wall. So you can do that if you're just starting out. But if you don't want to wreck your walls, then you should get some great stands. So I actually got this 3-pack of C-stands that are super durable. I can use them as light stands, put things on them, so many things, and they are a really, really great investment. So now let's look at actually setting up our mini at-home studio. All right, so when it comes to actually setting up your mini studio, it's great if you have a bit of space that you can move around in, but you really don't need that much space to create this look and to set this up. So what you're gonna need is set up your table, then you're gonna do your C-stand and we're gonna put this arm into the side here. And then what we can do is we can just put our backdrop paper right on. It just slides right on very, very easily. You can pull it out, cover the whole table, and clamp it down at the ends. Next up, you can do natural lighting. That's why I didn't say that a light was 100% necessary for this, but honestly, lighting will make your photos a lot easier, much easier to control. You can do them at any time. So I'm using a continuous light. This is the Aputure 120D. This is what I use for videos and it works well for photography as well. Probably a strobe light would be the ultimate if you were gonna go super professional level, but continuous lights are really, really amazing. So next we're gonna talk about tripods, and this is something that's really important. So typically, you know, you have a tripod that looks something like this, and if you wanted to do product photography, this is great if you're gonna shoot straight on, you know, with that in the background. But if you wanna do a flat lay, you start to become really limited in your options. So for example, I can angle this down, but what's gonna happen is that these tripod legs are gonna actually end up being in the shot. So what's really cool about this tripod is it has this swing arm, which is really, really neat. And this was not expensive considering how durable it is, how much you can do with it. So I was really happy to find something like this. So basically with this one, all you do is you unlock this here, pull that up all the way, and then it goes like that and you can push that right through. And then what you have is a great overhead system. Now, the other thing that's cool with this tripod is that you can shoot it this way if you wanna get the top down. I could make the legs a lot longer, have it on the ground and just this part over the shot, or I can actually take this apart and have this coming from underneath to get my shot. So a lot of options with a tripod that gives you those abilities. And I think that if you are doing product photography, please, please look for a tripod. It's gonna give you a lot more flexibility. All right, so we talked about what you need, setting up all your gear, and now we're gonna talk about how to make your photos pop. Now, the one thing that you have to remember with product photography is that the product is the star. You don't wanna be thinking about what's the coolest photo I can take, you wanna be thinking about what is the best photo to sell this product. So here's a few examples for you that a series I recently did, and these are gonna be the similar vibe that we're gonna do today. These are a holiday jewelry series, and so I put in the presents. We have, you know, the different holiday type flowers around in the corners. So we're conveying a message without saying it. And that is that, hey, do you need gifts for anybody? These would be a great gift. Are you going to holiday parties? So that's what we're gonna talk about doing right now. And I'm gonna show you guys how you can do it with some props and your product. So let's take a look at some props that you could use in a shoot like this. So I have presents, I have some flowery garland, I have twinkle lights, and just some other fun little holiday accents. Okay, so phone cam there, top-down camera of the flat lay that we're actually kind of creating here up top. So we'll hit record on that. So the first thing that you wanna start with is your product. So we have this cute, bright red hat. So you wanna make sure that you don't have a lot of lint on the photos. If you're doing clothes, you don't want wrinkles, please iron or steam them. Make sure that the product looks perfect and center it up right in the middle. I actually got this at the dollar store. Very, very easy, good thing to work with. Kind of put it around the edges. I think the big thing that you wanna focus on is your four corner. So go in the corners there to fill in your shot. The other thing is that I have a 24 to 70 millimeter lens here. So the 24 to me is seeming like I have way too much extra space. So I'm gonna zoom that in a little bit. This is a little bit wider because I'm actually taking a video to show you this angle, not a photo, but that is a bit of a better look there for it, I think. So you just kind of focus on the corners. I think we can definitely have a red plaid box down there in the corner. Maybe have the little tag sticking out. Get those flowers popping up. You want to really pay attention to, you know, what elements you're featuring. I think over here we'll put that around. And you want, as we kind of talked about before, you want to have that negative space. So we don't want to completely, like we wouldn't want to do something like this. We wouldn't want to start filling up really close to it. We need that white negative space to show off the product. The other thing that you can do is that you can use what I like to call supplementary products. So something else that's in the collection or the series, like I have this big scarf here. You can actually just have it maybe coming off to the sides. People might see it out of the corner of the eye, and then when they see it again, they'll be even more intrigued. So I'm not gonna take over with this product, but I'm just gonna kind of like put it to the side, kind of to create more of that vibe. So something like that is actually looking really good at this point. I'd probably go along and finesse it even more, get those lights showing it a little bit more, but this is sort of to show you. You have your product right in the middle, then kind of focus on those four corners. So for this next setup, I'm gonna shoot right into the background. So the white scoop really, really helps. Put a few presents in the background there just to, you know, give the vibe of everything. And then I have the light off to the side and also a practical little lamp in the background giving kind of a warm glow. Just really make sure when you are doing your lighting that you're paying attention to shadows that you might be creating. You might need to move your light to a different angle or more of a top-down angle if you want to eliminate shadows. So just keep an eye on that. And then here I'm just putting some fun little props in the foreground just to make the shot a bit more interesting and add some depth. All right, so we finished taking our super awesome photos. We're so happy with them. We sit down to edit them and the card is corrupted. Everything's lost, a whole day's work and the client wants them. We're just sitting crying in the corner. That would be pretty terrible. So that brings us to the sponsor of today's video, which is PPA. And I wanna talk about the resources that they have for small businesses that are really, really crucial and can really help you out if you need them. So the first one is data loss recovery, photo care insurance, and PPA EDU. First off, data loss prevention. This coverage is designed specifically for photographers and their small business with data loss recovery services and even your legal fees if you find yourself with a really unhappy client. PPA has also upgraded their equipment insurance, so now you can get full replacement coverage with a flat $350 deductible, or you can repair your equipment with a flat $50 deductible. And of course, PPA's online education platform, they've recently upgraded this as well, and it features over 900 online videos and tutorials on how to grow your business. There's topics like branding and entrepreneurship, so a lot of really great tips there. So if you want to join a community of over 31,000 photographers, click that link in the description below and you're going to get a special discount on a PPA membership today. All right, guys, the photos are not corrupted though. They are okay. So we're going to jump into editing these pictures. Now, the fun thing with editing product photos is that it's actually really easy because we've already controlled for all the variables. We have our lightings, we have our settings. Not much is changing photo to photo. It's not like outdoor or lifestyle where it could be super sunny one second and then cloudy, your white balance keeps changing. You don't have those variables. So once you kind of edit your first photo, you're basically golden, but there are a few tips that you should know. So let's jump into it. Okay, so we're here in Lightroom, and the first thing when you're kind of going through your photos is just sort of pick out which one is your favorite in terms of how everything is coming together. Now, I really like this shot, but as you can see, I have a shadow here that I just sort of missed when we were doing the shot. So if I had another version, I would opt for something that didn't have any really harsh shadows like that. So I think this other angle that I did of this shot actually gives us a better overall look. So the first thing that we want to do is we just want to do some basic color correction. I'm going to bring up the highlights because I do want that white background to really pop. And I think I'll also warm this up a little bit. If you do it too much, you're going to create like a warm hue to the white or a blue hue. So find that balance where, you know, you sort of like how it's coming across. I'd bring up the shadows a little bit as well, just because we want all those details to really show and do a little bit of contrast, maybe increase the clarity a little bit. And then we can go into some things like colors. Now, you never want to change a color in a product photo. It still needs to be the real color so that when people buy it and it shows up at their door, they get what they ordered. But you can also just make sure that you're doing that. You can add some luminance there, like on the red, adding that luminance really makes it pop. You might find other colors are distracting. So for instance, the green, I might actually bring down the saturation and the luminance on it, just so that all these pieces in the edges are really just there to support and not distract. Now let's go over to our other setup down here. Now, one thing that we want to do is never have any lint, any dust, wrinkles in the clothing. If you do, you're going to want to go in and edit those away. So I'm going to pick that heel tool and I'm just going to go over all of the little bits that kind of create a distraction in the image. So that's looking pretty good there. Now I might want to make the hat pop out even more. So I'm going to go over to the brush tool. Lightroom actually has a new feature where if you just press select subject, it thinks for a minute and it will actually just highlight the main subject. So it did it perfectly on this hat. So now I can actually bring up the clarity or the texture just on the hat because the background, the foreground, I want that to stay blurry. So I'm gonna bring up the texture, the clarity, and the contrast a little bit to show, you know, that black and white contrast. And then overall, that is looking really good. Once again, I'd go down into these colors. I'm gonna up the luminance on the red and maybe the saturation. Here, it doesn't matter so much if I change the color of the red because that's not what is actually being sold in this picture. But overall, that is looking really great. So that's how easy it is to do super simple product photography right at home. And I hope you guys can see how simple it is to get really, really amazing photos when you have some great gear and you take some time to plan those shots. Now, if you are starting a small business or you've been at it for a while, I definitely think you should check out PPA. If you click that link down in the description below, you're gonna get a special deal on a membership today. So definitely check it out. All right, guys, I will see you in the next video. Peace out. Love you lots.